Hi guys. Okay, so I did a little shopping. A little bit. I went to my local Dollar Tree, actually two of my local Dollar Trees, and I was kind of surprised at both of them. But I wanted to share a little of what I got. So, as you know, about this time, if you haven't seen all the videos yet, Dollar Tree has started getting in all of their Halloween and fall, and it is too cute. Gosh, I'm looking at my hair. But I got a lot. I didn't get as much as I thought I would because I keep seeing everybody else's hauls and everything, but nobody has anything. Like, my stores they're not fully stocked yet, which I was kind of surprised because they were in the middle of like all these boxes, and I went back in later afternoon and not everything was there. But anyway, I was just going to share what I was able to find, and I was really happy to get. I even had to go back because I accidentally dropped something, and I had to pick it up again. So we'll go ahead and just get started, and I'll show you what I got. And let me go ahead and turn this off. There we go. Okay, so I don't even know where to start. There's so much stuff. I'll start with the smaller things, sort of. So one of the things that I found that was really cool were these bottle brush trees. And I was really surprised because they're really big. And I mean, I used to work for Michaels, so you know that I've like gone in there. I always comparison shop from what I used to get to now. And when I measure these, they're coming up about 8 inches. Yeah, so they're coming up about 8 inches on there. This guy's a little bent, but not too bad. There you go. And they had four colors. They had the orange, they had the green. It's a little bit more sprucey looking on the video, but it's actually a brighter green. And they all have glitter. So there's those two. And then there's also the purple and the black. So super cute. Like I said, I don't know if it's picking that up, but they're both very, very glittery and super cute. All right. So we got all four of those. Like I said, they're all 8 inches, and that's pretty good. These bottle brush trees are usually a lot. I mean, I know that Michaels used to get like the little guys in a little pack, and they cost like way more. The other thing I picked up besides the bottle brush were just some of these guys, just so I could decorate a couple of things. The one thing I did not like was that the person packing it put these in with my food. That was not fun. I'm gonna put those on the floor just for now because glitter's falling off of those like crazy. Yeah, so just on the side for a snack, I grabbed these guys, and like now the bag's all full of glitter. But like, they have tahini peach rings. So had to get the crafter snack. All right. The other thing I got, which ended up out of the bag already because you couldn't help but take them out and check them out, were these little mushrooms. Let's see if I get those on there. How cute are those mushrooms? They are these cute little mushrooms, just like that. And they're wood, and they're actually really well made. I was really surprised. I thought they were going to be like maybe really light, weird, or I thought they were going to be like glue everywhere or something like that. I mean, some of them have that little, you know, burnt wood or something like that, but they're super duper cute. These ones are about, yeah, a little over an inch and an eighth about on these guys. So they're pretty good size. You get 8 of them in a pack, and they have, I'm seeing on everybody else's hauls that they have acorns and a different shaped mushroom, and I forget what the other shapes. There was a bunch of different shapes, and I want to go back and find them, but I wasn't able to find them at mine. They come in the little tag like this, and you get 8 of them. Okay. But I want to go back and get more mushrooms because they're super cute, and I can put them in all kinds of stuff. And then the other thing we got are these guys, these little cats. So I can make a banner out of these, and I'll show that later. The hats. Now, I've bought these at Michael's before, and I didn't get like 8 of them in there. I think I got like 2. These ghosties. These pumpkins. So, I mean, for a buck each, it's 8 each. And these ones are pretty big. I think they're all about the same size. I got 3.5 inch on the pumpkin. The ghost is measuring almost 4 inches. Almost 4 inches on the hat, about 3.5. And the cat at Ty's point is almost 4 inches. So they're pretty big. I guess they're not small. I had big hands. So wrinkling up. Then I have these really, really, really cute velvety pumpkins. They're different sizes and they're squishy. These are like still just squishy. I saw somebody show white ones. I couldn't find the white ones. But you get 5 in here, and I would say about 2 inches with the stem. They're all a little different, but not very much. But I'd say about 2 inches maybe with the stem. Oh, that's a cute one. The other thing they had were fabrics. Oh, so much glitter. I'm not one that cares too much about the glitter, but it's a lot right now. Okay, so they had fabrics. I'll show you the Halloween ones I picked up. They had a couple more, but these are the Halloween ones I picked up. So this one has like cute little cats with different color eyes that are really cute. Then we have the candy corns and the polka dots with the bright green. Then there's the like Day of the Dead sugar skull one. It's really cute. Then there were for fall, and like I said, there was more for Halloween. But for fall, I got these pretty sunflowers and this pretty little plaid to match. There were fall leaves. They came out kind of bright. They're not as bright as they seem on there. And then there's this one. I'm actually going to pull this one out because you kind of can't see it. This one has a really cute, like, buffalo check, whatever, gingham print with the truck on it and pumpkins and sunflowers. See that? How cute is that one? So it's a little bit of everything on this one. And they measure 20 by 21 inches. So you can get an idea of how big you're getting each one. Good size. I mean, you can make a few cute things out of these. I'm going to use them to make, some of them I'm going to use to make pumpkins, some for like cute little signs, mostly pumpkins, fabric pumpkins. But again, recap for a buck. And then we are going to go to the stickers. They had a bunch of different stickers. I got most of them. And then one of them I have 2 of only because my daughter wanted it also. So we got her one. All right. So the first one is this cute fall one. Super cute. There's like, and they're dimensional, just a little dimensional. So it's really cute. I really like that deer and the little mushrooms. There's a pumpkin pie, the truck, coffee, bushel basket full of stuff. And they're all, almost every single one of them is dimensional, I think, except for the pumpkin pie and some of the leaves. There's this one for Halloween, super cute. And again, almost all of them are dimensional. These up here are flat. The rest of these are dimensional. I can fill them, except for that ghost. But how cute are these ones? So this is the one I have 2 of because my daughter wanted one too. And then this one. This one's really cute. I really like this one. Not cute, but it's pretty to me. Even this one's dimensional. You kind of see which ones are dimensional, which ones are not. This one's really pretty. This one's really cute. I'm pretty sure everybody's been posting this one particularly because of the colors. You get the pretty colors in there. And sorry, I left my window like wide open so that way hopefully I was getting more light, and I think it's kind of playing around with it. But how cute is that one? These are cool. So these ones are more like a thin cardstock with dimensional stickers, but this one is this almost metal-ish look to it. Let's see if I can catch that in some good light. Let's try that. Actually, a little better. But do you see the dimension on that? And it makes it look like metal. Let me get it out of the package so maybe you can see that a little better. But it makes it look like metal stickers. So they have a nice kind of foily look to them. Oh, I didn't even notice that. It's almost like a clear moon around it. Look, you can see the dimension on them. And these skulls are all raised. They're heavy, heavy in glass. But these are really cute. I love the way they look. There, you can see them a little better. And then there's this one. This one has like Hocus Pocus Boo. Spooky Night. A little more mystical looking. Oh, and I think I picked up two of these. I did somehow. I don't know why I ended up with two of these, but I ended up with two of these. I didn't mean to. Maybe I was grabbing another one. I might have missed one that I thought I was getting. All right, so that's that. I did also just pick up some more foam brushes. Good tip is when you can get foam brushes from the Dollar Tree, grab them from like the tool area. You get more in a package than you do if you get it in the craft area. You get 8, and I think in the craft area you only get like 5 or something. All right, now for some of the big guys that I got. So I got the wireframe pumpkin. They had a wireframe pumpkin. They had footballs. They had a witch's hat. What else did they have? I forget what the other one was. There was something else. And of course, they have all the regular round ones and stuff like that. This one, I just think it's a little funny because it's so wide. I think it's going to be kind of weird. I'm not 100% sure what I'm going to do with this version, but I do know I need a new Halloween thing, a Halloween wreath or something for my door. But I'm thinking it's going to be a lot of tied rags on this or like scraps. I'm not sure still. I'm still thinking about that guy. But I mean, for a buck. Off of Halloween, this is one of the other things only that I didn't. I got me a bunch of these to put in my calyx, my Target version of my calyx things. You can kind of see one over there just sticking out a little bit. But these are cool. I'm sure you've seen these, but I did grab these, which will probably help hold onto all of my Halloween stuff too. But I like these storage things. Oh, wrong way. Because these latch off like that and they just look done. And then last but not least were the wood signs. I'll show you that. And my little skull. Okay, I've seen people post that they actually had several different versions of the skull, okay? And I only found this one, and it happened to be just hanging around. I have a feeling in my area, we have a big Day of the Dead thing, like a bunch of Day of the Dead vendor things. So I don't know if they're going to happen this year, but I know that somebody goes and buys these every year from like all the Michaels and everything. So I'm pretty sure that when they saw Dollar Tree had them, that's probably somebody grabbing them all up. Did that, or they just never finished putting them up. Let me see if you can see it better like that. Okay, I know better on the light. Hello, Jenny. I don't know if you can see it. Oh, sorry. Okay, so now I know better not to leave the curtain open, but how cute is that one? The detail's pretty cool, like the flower on it. I'm waiting to see like if my store gets more of these so I can see what the rest of them look like, because I really want to pick up a few. But there is like somebody that like paints them and sells them in town that I know. All right, the cute signs, wood plaques. So there's this wood plaque. The matching, I guess you can say. A little Frankie. And then we've got Day of the Dead matching. I love the rose that they put on this one. And then they put a hat on this guy. So my thought on some of these, and I'm probably going to go back and get more of the different shapes, because of course they had cats and pumpkins and everything else. They have so much. I'm pretty sure. I know I'm not the like only one making these videos for the Dollar Tree, because I've watched about a dozen of them. And then the last thing I picked up was this trick-or-treat, which is going to be the center of my wreath. I do know that I want this for the center of my wreath. So I will be showing projects on how I paint all this stuff up and what I do with everything. Oh, actually, not last. I almost forgot this guy. These. I can't even get the whole thing in there. Look at this. These are crazy. So I saw on somebody else's haul video that they have a plain version, unfinished wood version. This is the like chalkboard version of them. It's black. I don't know how chalkboardy this really is. Just black. But somebody else posted an unfinished version. That's cute. A cute little pumpkin cutout at the top. The other one also had a pumpkin cutout. It could be an apple, but I look like a pumpkin cutout to me too. But this is super cute. And this guy is huge. I don't know if it has the size on it. I can't read it. Let me see how big it is. I just have my measuring tape right here. This guy is 23 and a half inches by 5 3/4. So it's pretty big, you guys. And these guys, I forgot to measure these guys out for you. I mean, I'm like astounded because I've seen these at Michael's like a million times for way more. These are 12 inches. And they're all about 12 inches, I want to say. Yeah, they're all about a good 12 inches on each one of them. So I would say, because I know in my town, the truck comes Monday. No, sorry, Mondays and Fridays, I want to say. Something like that, Friday. So I know the truck was there. I went yesterday to the one Dollar Tree that was right by my house. And I know the truck had just, I know the truck comes then. They were putting everything out. And they had boxes like crazy still out. So I was hoping that if I came back later, and I wasn't totally thinking of coming back later, but I had found out that I had dropped my orange one. Because when I came to unpack everything, I was like, wait a minute, I don't have my orange tree. So I went back to go find it later, way later in the afternoon. I went in the morning, went back later in the afternoon. My Dollar Tree sold out of almost everything within hours of putting stuff out. Luckily, was able to get most of the stuff I wanted. That's good. See, the one thing I really just want to go back for is some of the signs. But when I went back later, they still hadn't finished putting stuff out. I know they had it. I went to another Dollar Tree, and which is usually like my go-to Dollar Tree when I can't find stuff anywhere else. It's a little bit further out, not too much further. But they didn't have like anything. Almost everything was not there compared to what they usually have. It was crazy. I was like, what's going on? They hardly had, they had basically the same stuff that the other store had just started putting out, but a little less. But again, like I said, I believe all the dollar stores have the Dollar Trees, like in my area, get their trucks on Friday, so they might not have finished because it is a busier Dollar Tree. So I'm hoping that maybe if I go back, I'll find more. I didn't see these guys at all, and I really want to go back and get like a bunch of these. But don't forget that you can order online most of these things. So if you need something in bulk, like these guys, you can actually order these in bulk. And I believe there's four different designs online. I will put a link in here after the live, but I'll put a link in the description later for my Dollar Tree, like affiliate link. I don't know. I don't really get much out of it, but anything helps. But yeah, I'll put a link in to the Dollar Tree site after, to some of these cool things. There's some of them you can get in smaller quantities. Other stuff you have to order like 12, 24, 36. So that's the only thing you want to be careful with if you're ordering online. You can have them, you can pick them up in the store for free shipping. So that's the cool part. So if you need certain things in bulk for any crafters that maybe make and sell, that's the best way to get it because you'll get a variety and it's pretty cool. Get together with some other people in your town that maybe have, you know, craft with you and split the cost on some of the things that come in. Like I said, the only thing I want to get quite a few more are these guys. I might actually give them out. I might sell them. I don't know. I doubt it. I don't like to sell. I like to show you how to make things. I don't like to sell as much. So if you'd like, stay tuned after this live. I'm going to finish this live. Give me like 5 minutes after this live and I will show you my Brutus Monroe haul. I just want to keep the video separate. Also, just keep on the lookout for some other tutorials and stuff that are going to be coming. One of the cute things that I made, because my daughter decided she wanted to make a mushroom hat, and I was trying to figure out a theory on how she can make it, and for some reason I ended up making this really cute mushroom. Isn't it cute? I love it. So now I want to make like 50 million of these guys. So I will have a tutorial on how to make this guy coming out soon. Okay. Thanks for watching. See you later. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Dee, dee, dee.